Oh my god, these headphones are hot. I should not have a heater on right now. God damn it. Although it is a cold day, so who knows. Anyways. Okay. So let's start off with the areas that we couldn't check previously. Headmaster room, control room, bio room, stuff like that. Wait, what? How do I... What's the button again? There we go, okay. That should be all the way up on the fifth floor, right? There we go, okay. Yeah, plenty of places to go to. Alright, let's start off with the top left-hand corner, the biolab. Alright, get rid of that. We didn't enter here before, so... wonder what lies around here. Well, here I am in the biolab. It's so cold! It's like, abnormally cold. I feel like I'm in a giant freezer. Seriously, why is it so cold? Alright. Anything to search for? Okay, cameras and TVs. I don't think I need to worry about that. What's this tarp? There's a stack of tarps here. I've been seeing a lot of those things lately. Alright. Locker, freezer, and the desk. And more lockers, okay. Let's look at the desk. Oh, it's so cold, but why is it so cold in here? It's the first thing you need to figure out. There's some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. And on the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. And on the other side, they're all deactivated? There's some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. I've seen something like this before. Ah, that's it! I've seen this kind of thing in a horror movie. In the horror movies and stuff. It's a fridge for storing dead bodies. Oh shit. Does this mean this biolab is actually a morgue? I should probably take a closer look. Okay? 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 Okay, we'll do that! We'll do that. Okay. Okay, how do we search? How do we search for the dead bodies? I can't check it though. I think we need some sort of key or passcode or what? Is there passcodes in here? It looks like an instruction manual. We offer an eco-friendly alternative to standard dry ice for all of you cadaver needs. In addition to the germicidal lamps, we also provide an ozone generator for the removal of ethyl gas. Simply insert the cavitator and the blue light will let you know the automated system have been activated. Temperature and humidity levels will be adjusted automatically for optimal settings. With our systems, anyone can keep a body fresh as Daisy for as long as you need. In the unlikely event of a problem, the red light will activate and an alarm will sound immediately. The exterior is stainless steel, and we do offer an optional leather for the fridge. Well, looking around, I think I get it. Seems clear to me now. Some kind of makeshift morgue. Alright, so this is what the biolab is. And about those lights by each slot. It looks like it's set up so that the slot is occupied, the blue light comes on. Which would mean inside each slot lit up in blue. Another one of the victim is... Okay. I can't let my emotions take control of myself right now. There's only one thing I can do for everyone who's died. And that's to defeat the mastermind. To do that, I have to continue my investigation. I don't have any other option. Alright, so we're done in this room, I'm guessing? We can't search for dead bodies, I'm guessing. Although at the same time, I'm not sure if they're like any... relation to Well, then again, we're trying to search for every nook and cranny in this area, right? So, probably one more, and then if there's nothing there, then yeah, we'll go out. So, biolab, check. Where else do we need to go now? We go to... Why is the exclamation mark still there? Garden. Well, I guess we also need to check there just to, like, revisit the crime scene. Now, is the dead body still there, is the question. It doesn't look like it, so... Huh? It's gone. Makuro's body. It's not here? Well, what'd you expect? There are still just 4 chickens left. Honestly, you'd be kind of terrified if there were one more than that. Maybe the body's inside the tool shed. Better check just to be sure. Do I need to go back in order to find the freaking body? I didn't find anything even close to a dead body. Well, if it's not here, then it must be... could be in the biolab? But corpses aren't the only thing I need to check in there. There's one other thing. That tarp. Okay. Yeah, there's a tarp here too, so I'm wondering what the hell. The killer used the tarp to keep the sprinklers from getting the body wet, which means the killer might have left some clue behind here. Huh? I didn't notice this before, but there's a small stamp on one corner of the tarp. It says Biolab. Then this originally came from the Biolab? Okay. Is that everything in this room? I think so. Yeah, I don't think anything else is related to the case. What is this thing for? A pickaxe. On the handle it says, Crazy Diamond. It's the same thing that was written on the back of Mondo's coat. This pickaxe is connected to Mondo somehow. Strange. Yeah, I think we are done searching in this area specifically, so we don't need anything else. I guess now we go back to the biolab and actually search for that body. That's all I really need to check here. Alright, the game's confirming that I don't need to go back here again. Even though there's still that exclamation mark, which kind of confuses me, but and whatever. If the game says we're not allowed back here, then okay. Don't need to go back here then. Yeah. Okay. There's a stack of tarps here. I've been seeing these a lot lately. Okay. Makuro's body disappeared from the garden. Could it be in here? I need to check, but I have no idea how to open this thing. Instruction manual? Unless it's not in here. I might have to reread through the instructions just in case again. But for now, it seems like we might have to investigate somewhere else and then come back to the battle lab later. Where's the next place? The dojo. Alright. Place we've technically already been to, but like, you know, just in case, cover every corner. God, the controls are so weird. I don't know why you don't strafe or anything, but then whatever. Also, what the hell's Toko doing here? You find anything here? Oh, Toko, so this is where you were.
What do you want?
Am I so disgusting you want to want me out of your sight? Yes. Okay. Not finding anything, not seeing a clue. Why did I forget to put the timer on? I am an idiot. I figure since this place is related to the case, we'd have to have something, right? But there aren't anything out of the ordinary. Jesus Christ.
What's your problem?
Okay, Senpai noticed me, bitch. I'm just gonna go into this corner. Yeah, I'm just gonna go into this corner and figure shit out myself. But it's just that the masterminds attempt to frame Kyoko. Fully imagine Sakura out here using this to train. What else is there? This thing? Oh, that's the ladder. And not the ladder, the fucking... yeah. Anything in the targets? Seems perfectly far away. I'm so amazed to see people can do a bow and arrow. All that for the money, 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 cause it's all about the bling, bling. Okay. What else is there? Cherry blossoms in a suit. A suit of armor display is extremely Japanese. Oh, like you? I wonder, so is there really nothing here? Yeah. So this place, honestly, I feel like might actually be useless. Okay. So that covers all the fifth floor areas. Onto the fourth floor, we have the data center. Enjoy. Alright.
Hey, Makoto!
Hey, Makoto! You're here to look around, too? Is that what you're doing here? Yeah, I can't help but wonder about that Monokuma door.
Yeah!
So I figured, if all the doors in the school had been unlocked, that one should be open too, right?
But...
although, I couldn't bring myself to open it. Because it might explode, right? And that's really suck, so you open it! So you want me to die instead? I'm sure she didn't mean it, but she made it sound like she was okay with me getting blown up. Okay. So I'm guessing there's nothing around this area specifically, so... okay, so... I guess I'll open it. Ah! Wait! Let me take cover first! I don't want to get exploded! God damn it, Aoi! Okay, go ahead! There goes nothing. I threw all my weight into it, but the door opened much easier than I expected! There was no explosion, thankfully. My first impression was...
huh?
Whoa, this place is totally sci-fi! Yeah, I was kind of thinking the same thing. Alright, you got anything to talk about?
What the heck?
I mean, every part of the school leaves a bad taste in my mouth, but...
just a second!
This place is like a number of one gross. It's in a whole different league of creepy. Okay. What is this device? It looks like some kind of control panel. It's really over the top, though. Like some kind of military installation or something. Yeah, it kind of looks like a mech cockpit, right? Ifumi'd probably freak out if he saw it. Cockpit? So the Monokuma room has been a control panel that looks like some kind of cockpit. And could that mean...
okay.
Alright, let's start poking at it, or whatever. I'm gonna start pushing buttons! Oh no, you can't just do whatever something like this! But it was too late. Launching Nuke 2 Japan. Shit. And he already jabbed away at the control panel.
Huh?
Huh? Did you hear that? Yeah, I think it came from the other room. Hina, what did you push? I'm totally not sure, but I think it was that one. The button that says data center. Data center? I took a good look at the control panel, and I saw a bunch of buttons, each with the name of the room next to it. And just like that, Hina said there was one labeled data center. That must be the one she pushed. But the data center? That's right next door. The room we were just in. That's where the strange noise came from. I'll probably check it out.
Yeah.
Yes, please! I'm kinda scared to get out of my mind right now, so I'll just let you cheer on from now, or from over here. Okay. Monokuma, I'm guessing. So, this place controls Monokuma, from my understanding, right? Did you hear what I think I heard? Is that Monokuma? So this thing controls Monokuma then. Hey! Yarr! Give me all your- Is that you, Aoi? Is that you, Hina?
What?
Aw, man, busted. How'd you know?
Say what?
Anyway, what is this? Some kind of remote control cameras kind of setup? You don't even know what you're controlling?
Hello.
Well, I mean, I can't really see anything from in here.
Found it!
Ah, guess what I found? A self-destruct button. Whatever you do not push it!
Too bad!
Aw, man! We seriously gotta push it?! Anyway, I guess that settles it. The room with the Monokuma drawing on it, and the control panel inside... controls Monokuma. Alright. Of course that would be Hina. Whoa, hey Makoto, what the heck was that just now? Monokuma. Huh? What do you mean? What you were controlling just now, it was Monokuma.
Huh?
Monokuma? What? For real? Yep, it looks like the panel definitely controls Monokuma. Which means the mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. Yeah, they were definitely in here. The mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. and the control room is totally separate from the data center area with all the monitors. In other words...
Hey.
Maybe the Mastermind can't monitor us and control Monokuma at the same time. Kyoko's theory was right.
But
if the Mastermind's been controlling Monokuma from here, that means they've been inside the school this whole time, right? I guess that would have to be true. But if that is true... It's a very polarizing approach, I know, but okay, enough puns. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure you're in blah blah blah, killing games, students, and... And the Mastermind Monokuma's puppeteer really is the 16th student? No, it can't be. There's no way, right? Well, we figured out what this room does. What's wrong, Wakoto? I don't like the face you're making. Oh no, it's nothing. Oh, okay. What about you? Is everything okay? Oh, well, it's just... This is where the Masterminds have been hiding, right? Who knows if they set up traps or something? I can't say it is impossible, but I really hope it's not true. You wanna leave soon? There's still lots of other places to check out. Yep, good point. Can't waste all our time staying around here. Alright. Let's get out of here, Aoi. I think we're done here. As soon as the door closed, I heard a strange sound. What was that? The door! It just locked on its own! What? My hand shot out to grab the doorknob. You're right, it's locked, but... Why? Of course it's locked, because the data center is now restricted! Monokuma?
Just a second.
Hey, no fair! You can't just go around restricting wherever you feel like!
Hey.
It's for your benefit! Because if that room stays open, I won't be able to move around! Imagine how depressed everyone would get if the school mascot just up and stopped moving. Then that room.
Yep.
As you may have guessed, that's where my controls are. So, right now you're being operated by someone in that room?
Yes, indeed.
Correctamundo.
You're a liar.
But that doesn't make any sense. We were just in there. We didn't see anyone. Oh, you didn't you? Oh, okay, so I'm guessing there's like another door there or something. Boo, are you sure you haven't been through as you could have been?
Ooh, maybe actually.
Did you happen to check a certain suspicious hatch? No way. The hatch on the floor! Oh, whoops. Derp. I think we got the bad ending. Boo, too bad. That was your one big chance and you blew it. Fuck.
Too bad.
Of course, that hatch can't be opened from the outside anyway, so whatever. Now then, the room is officially restricted, so now no more investigating. I'll be relying on you guys to tell the others.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's
gone, but...
So,
was he telling the truth? The Mastermind was hiding in there? In fact, if you think back to when we got locked out, the control room, that proves it for sure.
Huh?
Then, when I said we should have leave... Well, that hatch couldn't be opened from the outside, right? So, it's not your fault. Okay. Anyway, we don't have to let it get to us. We have to stay positive and make the most of the time for area. Okay. But there's one thing I'm good at. It's keeping my body moving.
Okay.
Okay. I'm gonna go run around and tell everyone what we found here. Nice. You've got all the motivation again.
You got it.
Alright. Cool. Alright. Next, area. So, data center. Monokuma is now a fucking student. Whatever. Okay. So, data center is now restricted. This is the headmaster room, where Byakuya is. Okay. That's gonna be some fun interactions. Okay. So, what's going on around here? This is the headmaster room. I've heard an awful lot about it, but this will be my first time seeing it for myself. Ah, Makoto. It's you. Oh, Byakuya! Alright, so what have you found so far? Or I could just look at the bookshelf. The bookshelf seems really well made, and it's filled with files and thick books. Well, you came to the right place this time. Would you like to see something interesting? Sure. What do you mean something interesting? Take a look at this. It was on the top of the pathetically Give me easy words, goddammit. Class 78, student registry? It contains profiles for all of us and Makuro.
So in other words...
Apparently, class 78 refers to us. Wait, we found Makuro's profile in Kyoko's room.
I see.
That's right. It also mentioned class 78. This means... this must be where Kyoko got that page. And since the rest of our profiles are listed here along with hers,
in other words,
there can be no doubt Makuro was a student here at Hope's Peak Academy, just like the rest of us. Makuro Ikusaba, the 16th student. That must be how Kyoko learned about this. But seems that Kyoko was in a hurry. Huh? What do you mean? Talking about where... when she stole it. The uneven tearing, the way the paper had been crumpled, she must have been in a hurry. Well, since she snuck in to get in, I'm sure she wanted to get out as fast as possible. But what's her point? She was in so much of a hurry that she only got the first page. The first page? Correct. Makuro's profile actually contains two pages.
So, in other words...
When it comes to this profile... There was more information about Makuro that we still didn't have. Alright. Why do you ask me to explain every little thing? You can read, can't you? This seems to be some sort of detailed report put together by the headmaster himself. I don't know what kind of man he was, but I'm glad he left us such an interesting clue. I was half listening to Byakuya as I skimmed through the report. Makuro reappeared suddenly. And in the background, an entity floats close, but just out of reach. Oh, hey, there's also Aoi Sahina there, too. The entity known as the Ultimate Despair? Right now, I can't be sure if it's a single person or some kind of group. Whatever it is, Makuro definitely has some sort of connection to it. I have a bad feeling about all this. I need to push forward to the Ultimate Despair. And I need to pay attention to Makuro's behavior, too. This is just my gut feeling, but I think she's dangerous. Despite the countless battles she must have gone through as a member of Fenrir. When she entered Hope's Peak, she didn't display any signs of battle wounds or scars. That fact alone proves her tremendous skill in battle. Naturally, I want to believe in her. She's one of my students, after all. But if I decided she's a danger to other students, I will be forced to take all responsible measures. Makuro was a part of the Ultimate Despair. I don't think there can be no doubt about it now. But wouldn't it mean Makuro and the Mastermind are allies? So why? Why would they kill Makuro? Plus, even the Headmaster seemed to be afraid of what Makuro was capable of. They would have had to take her completely by surprise to kill her like that. Or maybe it was the Mastermind is even stronger than Makuro was.
What?
What's wrong, Makoto? Huh?
That's fine.
You seem to be lost in thought, but I should probably point out one other thing. There's another important bit of information within the file you should note. What is it? Did you notice the picture in there? A picture of a girl perhaps you've never seen before. A girl who seems to be included as part of our class 78. This should be enough for you to figure out who this girl is. And further information about the girl is included in the file. 5'7", 97 pounds, and it even lists her as vitals, 31, 22, 32. Well, what do you think? What do I think? Are you asking me if she has like a nice...
Stop talking.
You hopeless idiot. What I'm trying to tell you is maybe you want to keep that in mind for later. Maybe you'll make your way back to the corpse and maybe you think, oh, could that mean... Oh... Okay, so I'm guessing there's a chance that the body isn't actually Makuro? Is that what he's saying? That is an interesting thought of note. Personally, what I'm thinking seems all but impossible, but it wouldn't hurt to confirm, right?
It's all clear now.
That's all I was trying to say. What you do with that information is your business. Okay. Alright. So I need to confirm the body, and from what I saw from her, it looks like she had like cornrows? This girl doesn't look like... Yeah. It's gonna be interesting. So probably the dead body we see was probably not even Makuro Ikusaba. Not only that, but like the autopsy said, the body was unknown and we don't know who it is, so it might not be Makuro. One last bit of advice from me to you, so I suggest you pay attention. Alright, well, here's advice from me? You seem to be getting along with Kyoko quite well. It's not that we're getting along, she's just done a lot to help me. Well, don't put too much faith in her. Huh?
In other words,
the cost of that faith might be more than you can afford. What are you saying? Just what I think. Call it a hunch. A hunch. But my hunches tend to be proven right. The advice is free this time. Take it or don't, as you will. I'll keep that in mind. Thanks. Okay, so what he's implying is to not trust Kyoko, or at least don't rely on her too much. Alright, let me see if there's anything else in the investigation room or whatever. Okay, nothing there. Oops. Wrong one. Okay, trophies. Hey, isn't this the sword as well? There are trophies and even a shield displayed in the case. Okay. What about this thing? This thing. Okay, apparently that's us. It has profiles of me and everyone I met at the beginning. And Makuro. Just like us, Makuro was apparently a nudist student. So I'm a part of the Ultimate Despair, which means her and the Mastermind should have been allies. Maybe they still are, maybe she's still alive and she's the Mastermind of all this. But then why would the Mastermind kill her? If she did, weren't they friends? I believe that's it for this room, maybe. Okay. So now we have... we still need to figure out how to open the damn thing, though. What is that? It's still fucking nighttime, holy shit. Not in real life, but like in this game as well. Okay. What other places that do we need to go exactly? This is the third floor, I don't think there's anything we need to go to the third floor. Second floor, there's probably something there, right? Library. Archive? No. That's the same room as yeah. First floor. Dormitory. Into almost every room so far. Feels like we really need to confirm what the dead body is though, but I feel like I'm missing some sort of information in order to how to open the dead body thing. And let's... now that we have all the information... it's one of the phrases to put the dead body inside. Alright. Is that the instructions, maybe? Okay, let me read the instructions one more time, just in case. Okay, it looks like an instruction manual. We offer an eco-friendly alternative, okay. In addition to germicide lamps, we also provide an ozone generator for the removal of gas. Simply enter the cadaver, and the blue light will let you know the automated system is connected. Temperature and humidity levels will be adjusted automatically for all people. Our systems, anyone can keep a body fresh as Daisy for as long as you need. In the unlikely event of a problem, the red light will activate, and an alarm will sound immediately. The exterior is stainless steel, and we do offer... okay, so the caviar, is somehow controlling wherever that is. Controlling the blue light as such. There's no red light on any of these so far, so there's no problem whatsoever. Just standard dry ice for all your cadaver needs. Okay. Insert the cadaver, and blue light will let you know the armor system is active. Okay, so it's only telling us that the body is still being frozen or frozen. Well, at least for these bodies. These seven bodies on the other hand. Seven bodies? Six students. Assuming Makuro Ikusaba is still alive, that's seven. there's 4 here, 5 here. 9. Okay. 9 plus 6. That's 15. So these have to be like the students of the dead bodies of each student. There's 7 here. Oh, wait, no, wait, what? There's 8. Oh, no, there's 7. There's definitely 7. So Mukuru Ikusaba is definitely still alive if that's the case. Although at the same time. Ooh, that extra body. Could be a reused dead body from one of the victims. Truth bones, there it is. Okay. Does it say anything about, or at least will make us look at it? Okay, no. Okay, so all the information here is newly presented. No old evidence has been used. Okay. So one of these dead bodies, we need to fucking figure out how to open them. Fridge that put the. Let me. Okay. Maybe I need some information from other students. Like maybe, Kirigiri could help me, Kyoko could help me. I just need to figure out where she is. Charge you go backwards, actually. Data center, blue lock, that. That master room, we already checked in there. I'm not sure if there's anything else we could search for. The classroom. Wasn't one of the classrooms actually, maybe we should search that even though there is no question mark there or whatever. Which classroom door is it though? I'm trying to remember. What is it? That's the headmaster room. Classroom we're talking about, or okay, just the one with like the bloody room or whatever. No, this is just a normal classroom. Okay. So those places, so it has to be like for A? Or is it a completely different letter? Oh wait, was it in the fifth floor? I forgot, it might actually be definitely in the fifth floor actually. Oops. I need to go back up there. Maybe there's information there that we need as well. This is, I don't think the music room has anything to do with anything. Was there any other rooms that we couldn't go, aside from maybe the locker rooms? Or sorry, the dormitory rooms? Yeah, let's check on top of the fifth floor in the, this room. I think it's this room. Oh, it's not this room either. Okay. This room? 5C? Yeah, it is. Okay. I don't think this has... This room has anything to do with anything, so... whatever the nook and cranny is, what the fuck am I missing? Garden? Did I miss something in the... It said that... goddammit. It said that was done here, but I guess just in case, then we'll check everything. What about this fucking huge-ass plant here, if I could gobble up and eat someone? Okay, I don't pick anything really here, so... Is that what else is- Oh! Kyoko's room! That's one of the rooms that we need to search because that was part of the investigation, right? So I guess we'll go to that place, then. Saka... Kyoko... Kyoko... Is she on the left side? think she's on the left side, actually. Last. Junko. Yakuya. Mondo. What the fuck? Where is she? She's the first one. This Kyokuzuma, I think she'd be very unhappy if I barged in without permission. Okay. Okay, so none of these have anything to do with the case. I'm guessing all the other rooms as well. I can't convert to what? Convert to go in and just sit around all day. Okay. Wait, what? That was an interesting last bit of information. Nothing to do with my investigation. No time for details right now. Right, Saika? Huh. As in, infamous there. Yakuza's room. If I set foot inside without asking to feed me with vultures. Okay, so I don't think I could. Yeah, I don't think I could enter anyone. Well, Toko will definitely kill me. The room's unlocked. It doesn't say anything else aside from the room's unlocked. Okay. Yeah, I don't think any of these rooms are accessible without a doubt, so... Hey, what? That's interesting new dialogue. I don't want to imagine what she'd do if I went in without telling her. Okay. I'm playing music while I'm doing a Let's Play, goddammit. These are in the doors unlocked, that's not doing the investigation. So whatever it is, I have to make sure... Damn it. I don't want to have any reason to go inside. Okay, yeah. All the rooms are inaccessible. It'll be interesting to see what it's looked like inside. Wasn't there also a room where, like, we go into the bathroom and that, like, whatchamacallit, that, like, the secret entrance or something? So all the rooms are unlocked. This doesn't include this big ass safe, where is it? Are we searching here? I really don't want to go in. If I have any choice at all, I never want to go in there again. Okay, so that's not an option. What's the room with a big ass safe again? Wait, is this the second room? Or second floor? No, this is the first floor. Blocked by a giant metal slab. Okay. So yeah, I doubt that thing's unblocked or anything. There's also a big ass gun here. Evil robot from RoboCop. Still a great movie. Okay. Okay. So what place am I missing exactly? So I can't go any of the dormitories. None of the rooms are giving me any advice as to where to go. Also, not only that, but... I'm gonna go back in here, see if I can like rattle or whatever. Also, I'm not seeing anyone else. Sucks, honestly. Where is everyone? Maybe, like, I, like, talk to those guys, like, where Yasuhiro is. Although, I'm not sure if he's gonna help me at all. Ugh. Garden, we already investigated that fully. Well, maybe we did miss something in the, dojo, because apparently it's a men... What the hell do we miss in the dojo? Actually, where is it? This is dojo. Okay. Let's talk to Toko. Maybe she has some new information. I don't. I think there are any clues here, so maybe I'm just gonna get going. Oh my god. This is so frustrating. Yeah, this room is useless. It has to be something from the bio lab, but like, how do we open the door? Something about like the caveat, but Dojo, useless. Let's go back to the, maybe I missed something at the, none there. The, headmaster room. I might have forgotten something, maybe. Come on. Let me talk to him one more time. Maybe I missed something else. Hey, Byakuya.
I don't have time to play with you.
Okay, so yeah, he's not willing to cooperate. Let me look at behind here again, maybe? Lava. Camera, I doubt there's anything there, but... Okay, that's repeating information already. Guys, I mean, I see like one of the U.S. presidents. I'm not sure what that's doing there, but I'll see. I'm guessing like some sort of Japanese dude. Or somebody. Okay, yeah. There's nothing in this room. I'm completely stumped here. My office. Have we been here yet? What is this place exactly? And I don't think it has anything to do with anything, but just in case, I guess. Just flowers, okay. This room has nothing to do with anything. Oh my god, okay, okay. What the fuck am I missing? Let me review the reports again. Review them and see what's up. Struck with a thick metal pipe, body was covered in wounds, but they were at least several days old. Okay, here we go. Some rooms have been locked up until that point. The headmaster room with the 4th floor, the biolab the 5th floor, Monokuma door, 4th floor, and the 2nd floor of the dormitory, the 2nd floor of the dormitory area. In addition, areas directly connected to Makuro, Kisawa's death are in the garden and dojo. Okay, so 2nd floor dorms. I already searched the dormitory areas, and honestly nothing happened there, so... Where's everyone else exactly? I'm only seeing like 3 people so far. Toko, and we already saw Aoi. Byakuya's here. No one in the physical lab, no one in the bathrooms, classrooms, rec room, no one. I don't even know what that song is or who's saying it. It just came out of my mind. Oops. Just came out of my mind in the first place. I don't know why. God damn, there's nothing. Dormitory first floor. Okay, so we should check dormitory second floor then, right? This is the gym second floor. Gym first floor. Okay. Let's try search around the dormitory on the second floor, then. I think that was it. Hold on. Because according to the thing, it's telling us to search around here? According to... Oops, not the map. According to the truth bullet. So, the second floor... dormitory. What room was locked, per se, here, exactly? I'm trying to remember. Oh my god, this place is like a jail cell or something. This is a library. I don't remember anything being locked here, though, that's the thing. Aside from boys and girls bathroom, maybe? Wait, no, was this the area that... Probably avoid going in and out of it too much. Okay, so we can't do anything in that area. So that's not it. Pool has nothing to do with anything, right? I must be missing something, because I am totally stumped here. What is this room? That's a classroom. What was our classroom specifically called? Number... what again? Okay, whatever. The Monokuma room in the data center opened to reveal a small... Oh man, that's not nothing. A tar found in the garden was played at part of Makuro's murder. Biolab had been stamped on in one of the corners of the tar. According to Headmaster report, Makuro did not have a single scar or wound when she came to the Hope's Peak Academy. In addition, her physical features were as follows. Okay. No scars or wounds when she arrived. I think that might contradict another evidence that we have. Biolab was on the fifth floor, seems to have been repurposed as a morgue. A corpse fridge has been installed in the biolab. It seems that the blue light comes on and indicates it as a slot is occupied. Okay, how the fuck do we open the fucking dead body thing? Where the hell is everyone? I honestly might need to look up a walk-up because I am so stuck here. You guys might be able to tell me, but by the time you guys tell me, I probably already did it. Let's check out the dormitory just in case. Maybe there's something. And I doubt it, but let's check the dining room. I don't think anyone's there, was there? Can you even fucking knock, seriously? If there's anyone there. Okay, all the other students are somehow missing or not present or whatever. Or may have nothing to do in relation to this case. Alright, where are we specifically? This is the first floor dorms. Was the AV room locked? I don't think so, but... check it out just in case. It's gonna probably be a huge list. No, the AV room was definitely unlocked. Maybe that's where the big secret was filled. Okay. Let's start this. I don't think there's anything in here. No, I shouldn't bother. Something in the biolab. Let me try going back there again. There's something I'm missing here. Or maybe I haven't talked to someone. I talked to everyone and they seem like they don't have any more information to give me. I can't find anyone else here, so... there's something in the biolab I'm probably missing. Where the fuck is this, like, caveat? Or caviar? Or whatever the fuck you call it. Not any of these. Under the tarp? Did I check the tarp before? It's like a tarp's here, I've been seeing those a lot lately. Okay, yeah, that totally helps. Monitor, does that... Monitor is fucking freezing to death, too. Maybe I could just, like, break one of those icicles and, like... I'm missing... something. I already have examined these two, like, forever. What the fuck do I do? Help? Can the game help? Observe. Fuck. Let me recheck. I'm about to give up, I swear to God. What is this? 5C. This is the one area that had, like, bloody everything, right? These faces are normal. What is this room? Wait a minute. What the fuck? Garden? Oh, it's a garden. Okay, never mind. Maybe I'm missing something in the shed. Maybe there was something in the shed that I missed out on. I need to check again. Maybe that's where the caveat is. Wait, what is this thing? Oh, I guess I'm gonna check the hoe instead. Fertilizer. I'm scraping every single, like, information I can gather. Because I am so confused. Alright, after this, I'm gonna look up a fucking block because I have no fucking clue at all. Hopefully, I don't get spoiled too much. He'll use a tarp to keep sprinklers from getting your body wet. I didn't. Okay, yeah, everything I searched for here is done. Everything from the dojo's done. I can't go back into the air. The control panel area, and I'm stuck in the fucking bio lab. And the headmaster room, no more information, and Yakuya is not willing to tell me anything. I don't think I can present this evidence like in Phoenix Wright, so I'm really stumped as to where the fuck I'm going now. The second floor dormitory, that's my next hint, I'm guessing, but like, there's nothing in the pool? Is there something in the pool that I missed? Probably something in the pool that I missed. Okay, that's fixed. The poster and shit. There's nothing in the pool. This locker? Nothing for me here. There's nothing for me here. Game. What the fuck is going to this area? God damn it. Okay, so pool area is done. Can't really do much there. Is there anywhere else on the second floor that I missed? Should I even go to the girls' bathroom exactly? Okay, no idea if I can't go into the girls' bathroom. Okay. Bathrooms. Nothing in the girls' bathroom. Classrooms? I doubt there's anything in there, but like, if any little information counts, then... Nothing. I'm really stuck, like, what the fuck? Am I missing something? It shouldn't be this stuff. Library, maybe there's something in there that I missed. Probably, hopefully, something on information on this letter, or I'll go into this area of the room. Okay, bunch of stuff, okay. Let's start off with this book shelf over here. Secret cats are going to. Presidential assassinations. None of these are useful. None of these are useful at all. Wait, what was the first area that we... God damn it, not there again. Where exactly was the first area that we found the, Mukuru Ikusaba document? Wasn't it here exactly? That's just the camera. God damn it, none of this area is just. So this area is useless. Fuck. I don't fucking know anymore, honestly. I'm gonna search more on the second floor. If there's nothing, then I give up. I'm probably just gonna look at the walkthrough. Is that really it? 2B? There's nothing in this class that might die. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna look up a walkthrough for this because I have no idea what the fuck I do afterwards. So... yeah. Reviewing all the truth bullets. Fucking examining almost everything I miss. I'm gonna feel like an idiot if the answer is really obvious. I'm sorry about this, like, whole, like, grind fest as to where the fuck I'm supposed to be going, but I really honestly don't know. So I guess in the next part, I'll just quickly watch a walkthrough or something, and I'll be right back. Thank you.